Hello, this is Glenn Lader from the National Weather Service in Tucson. This video will explain what type of weather is in store for Southeast Arizona this winter. 2017 has been a very warm year thus far for temperatures. For the period from January 1st to October 18th, it is the warmest year on record thus far in Tucson. There is a chance we will once again have the warmest year on record, which was previously set in 2014 and 2016. Precipitation is near normal thus far for the year. However, much of the rain this year occurred in July, with little rain since mid-August. The official temperature outlook from the Climate Prediction Center calls for a better chance of being warmer than normal, than either colder than average or near normal, across much of the southern United States this winter, including southeast Arizona. This is shown in dark orange. The precipitation outlook indicates in light brown where a drier than average winter is the most likely outcome, although the probabilities are slightly lower than they were for the warm temperature outlook in the previous image. Shown here are the normal precipitation totals for selected locations in southeast Arizona. December-January normals are shown on the left, and March precipitation is added into the totals on the right. Most valley locations normally receive 3 to 5 inches during the four-month period. Kitt Peak and other high elevation sites typically receive even more winter precipitation. So with the current forecast for drier than normal, most locations would not see totals this high. Our current drought state is abnormally dry with moderate drought over the western deserts. Given the expectation of below normal precipitation this winter, moderate drought will likely persist in areas already experiencing those conditions west of Tucson, with increased drought development expected across the rest of southeast Arizona. One factor that goes into the winter outlook is whether Pacific Ocean temperatures are warmer or colder than normal. Simply put, El Niño means that Pacific Ocean temperatures are warmer than normal, and La Niña means they are colder than normal. More specifically, the sea surface temperatures in a certain section of the eastern tropical Pacific, called the Niño 3.4 region, as shown in the top map, are at least half a degree Celsius above normal for El Niño, or half a degree Celsius or more colder than normal for La Niña. Also, these warmer cold temperatures need to be observed for 5 consecutive overlapping 3-month periods. As of autumn 2017, the ocean temperatures were colder than normal, as shown on the map in blue. The forecast is for those ocean temperatures to remain below normal with a 55 to 65% chance of a La Niña this winter. These maps show the prevailing jet stream positions during El Niño and La Niña during the winter season. During an El Niño winter, the warmer ocean temperatures generally results in the southern track of the jet stream to predominantly favor the southern tier of the United States. This usually steers weather systems across our area and brings wetter than average weather to southern Arizona. By contrast, La Niña winters are characterized by the jet stream being diverted away from Arizona, which usually results in a dry winter. With this year's La Niña only expected to be weak in strength, it may not be the dominant factor in the seasonal outlook, but a warm and dry forecast is nevertheless predicted. Even if the winter does end up being warmer and drier than average in southeast Arizona, that doesn't mean we still won't be affected by a winter storm or two. Remember, those storms can bring heavy periods of precipitation, wind, and freezing temperatures that can cause hazards for motorists and other impacts. So always keep on top of the latest forecast information so you don't get caught unprepared. In the longer term, impacts from a warm and dry winter include the possible development of drought and or dangerous fire weather conditions, especially as spring approaches. Thanks for listening to this presentation. For additional information about climate prediction, La Niña, winter weather, and preparedness, see the websites listed here. Many of these are linked from the National Weather Service Tucson website, weather.gov/Tucson. Stay safe this winter.